Hey, what's up, YouTube? Red and Bordy here, back with another New World video. We have a good one today. This is a complete guide to cooking in New World. Real quick, before we get started, don't forget to check the show notes for timestamps in case you're interested in a particular part of the video. All right, Bordy, take it away.
Yeah, man. So in this guide, we're going to go over an introduction to cooking in New World. We're going to give you guys some general tips about cooking. We're going to go over the different types of foods and buffs, where to find recipes, how and where to find cooking ingredients, how to level cooking in an efficient way to do so, items to enhance your cooking, and then we have a cooking experience table that we're going to briefly go over too. So Redlet, I'm going to jump right in here. We're going to give you guys an introduction to cooking in New World real quick. So the cooking profession in New World allows players to craft foods that regenerate health and mana, increase your attribute points, increase your luck while gathering, and increase your max gear score for an applicable trade while crafting. You can also craft fishing bait and dyes with the cooking profession. So in order to get started cooking, you just simply need to gather some cooking ingredients, make your way over to a kitchen or a campfire, and press the default key of E to begin your crafting. And cooking at a campfire is limited to recovery foods and bait, and you cannot craft any attribute food, trade, or dyes at your camp. So also important to note is the tier of your kitchen you're using. So you're going to be limited to cooking items of the same tier as the crafting station you're using or your camp as well. This applies to that too. So in order to craft in-game tier 5 food, you're going to need to find a tier 5 kitchen somewhere or a tier 5 camp to craft your tier 5 recovery food. So once you're at the crafting station, select the item you wish to craft. And if you have the necessary ingredients, then you're going to just select the craft button or use the slider that you see there, and you'll be able to craft multiple of the same item if you wish. So every time you cook an item, you're going to be rewarded with cooking experience, and as your cooking experience increases, so will your cooking level. So your cooking is going to be capped at level 200, and as you progress in cooking level, you're going to be able to cook higher tier food. So here's a pretty good tip for you that you may or may not know. Some of you that haven't done a lot of cooking in New World, make sure to pay attention to this one, because when you first start out, make sure you pay attention to the drop down menus for your food. So the game is going to default certain ingredients for your recovery foods and your food components. So if you've been out harvesting a lot of stuff and you've gotten some higher tier ingredients, sometimes the game will default those higher tier ingredients to craft some lower tier food. So make sure that you check your drop down. You can select from a vast array of ingredients to craft those foods. Some of the ingredients are much easier to come by than others. So make sure you don't use your rare ingredients that were selected by default when you're crafting that lower tier food. So whenever you select a rare ingredient, it's not going to enhance your lower tier food. If you utilize higher tier ingredients for the raw foods option, you're gonna have a chance to craft additional items, but the quality of the food isn't gonna change. Neither is the amount of experience you get whenever you use those. So also worth noting here is that you can place your ingredients, and this works for all crafting, not just cooking. You can place your ingredients in a storage and a settlement, and you can still access those ingredients at the cooking station. So you have to be in the same settlement that you have the items stored in, but you do not have to have them in your inventory. So one last quick note about the UI here before we jump into the different types of foods and buffs is that when you're cooking, you might see on your UI a message that says no bonus can be added to this item. So that is because that is going to be reserved for other crafting professions. So if you're like at an Arcana station, you're going to be able to apply special resources that are going to cause your crafted items to have like a specific perk. And you can use Azoth, which is going to increase the chances of your item having like attributes or gem slots. But whenever you're cooking consumables or food, you don't really have that option because you don't have attributes or perks that's going to be tied to your food. So that's why that says that no bonus can be added to this item. So just a quick note about the UI. So Red, why don't you tell everybody about the different types of foods and the different types of buffs you can get from foods?
All right. So the foods in New World are broken down into 4 different categories. Each category food ranges from tier 1 to tier 5. Of course, like most things in New World, you have recovery foods, attribute foods, trade skill foods, and food components. Recovery foods are to recover both health and mana. Health recovery foods will allow you to recover X amount of health. The higher tier food, the more health you will recover. It'll be per second for 20 seconds, but if you take damage, you will stop recovery. Afterwards, you will recover 1% of your health every 2.5 seconds for X minutes. And that, again, depends on the tier of food that you're consuming. Mana recovery foods are called energizing rations or meals. This type of food will grant you increased mana regeneration for X minutes depending on the tier of food that you consume. You will have, by default, the recipes to craft all 5 tiers of both types of recovery foods beginning at level 1. However, in order to craft the tier 5 recovery foods, you must work your way up to 150 level cooking and be at a tier 5 crafting station or a tier 5 camp. So here are the attribute foods, Bordy. They're broken down into the 5 core attributes of New World: strength, dexterity, intellect, focus, and constitution. Attribute foods will increase the specified attribute for a specific duration of time depending on the tier of food you craft. These foods also grant you health recovery while the food buff is active. You will only have access to tier 2 versions of these foods by default. You will have to find recipes for the remaining tiers. And we're going to go a little bit into that later on in the guide. So within each of these categories, you can craft a pure attribute food or a combination attribute food. For example, if you want additional strength attribute points, you can craft tier 2 pork chops and applesauce to get an additional 10 strength for 25 minutes. You can also craft a combination of strength and constitution, which should be good for tanks, by crafting cheesy broccoli soup. This would increase the strength by 6 and the constitution of your character by 4 for 25 minutes. The other attribute foods follow the same pattern. Whatever attribute food you are crafting will always have the attribute as the primary attribute. And then depending on the food you craft, you will have a secondary attribute as well. Trade skill foods are broken down into both crafting and gathering foods. For each gathering profession, you can craft a food that will increase your luck by a specified amount. And for each crafting profession that has associated gear score, you can craft a food that will increase your minimum or maximum gear score for crafted items for a specified amount of time. This applies to weaponsmithing, jewel crafting, engineering, arcana, and armoring. The last category of foods, called component foods, are simply ingredients that you will use for other recipes but have to be crafted for first. So, for example, cooking oil is used to craft game meat skewers. In order to get cooking oil, you must first craft this item by using fish oil and nuts. So, Bordy, we talked about recipes a little bit earlier. Why don't you tell us where we can find those?
Yeah, man. So by default, you're going to have access to all tiers of the recovery food, like we mentioned before, but you're only going to have access to up to tier 2 for attribute foods, tier 2 for gathering foods, and tier 3 for crafting foods. So the remaining recipes, you're going to have to find them throughout a turn by looting provision containers. So the higher tier the recipe you're looking for, the higher tier zone you're going to have to venture into in order to find the recipes. So recipes do not drop from every single provision crate. It's just a random roll based on your luck and the level of zone you're in, et cetera. So they can be pretty tough to find, so it might take a little while to obtain the recipes you're searching for. And recipes that are found, they are tradable, so you can also purchase them from the trading post if you can find them out there. So kind of a rough look at each zone that's going to attain what tier recipe. It kind of follows this pattern. So tier 3 recipes can be found level 16 through 38. Tier 4 is level 36 through 58 zone. And a tier 5 recipe, you're going to have to be in a very high level zone, like 56 plus. That's just kind of a rough map there to follow. So you can also find every provision container in New World by going and checking our interactive map. And you can filter by chest and then provisions. And then you can make yourself a route by going through and looting all of those provision containers to try to find some recipes. So, Red, how about you talk about how and where to find other cooking ingredients in New World?
So, cooking ingredients can be found in multiple ways. You can skin animals for meat, go fishing, loot provision crates, harvest crops from farms, harvest herbs from spices, and of course, buy ingredients from the trading post. All animal spawns can be found using the interactive map. Again, we do have all these ingredients marked out individually. So if you're looking for a specific type of ingredient, you can go over there and check that out. Obtaining meat, fish, and crops is straightforward. Obviously, you kill the animal and then skin it. For fishing, you go fishing. And for harvesting, of course, you got to find the farm for the appropriate vegetable or fruit. And those are all marked on the map again. However, spices are a different story, Bordy. Other ingredients can be a little bit harder to come by. Some ingredients are region-specific and can only be found in provision crates in that specific region. And we have a quick reference chart on our website as well that show all of those locations, the herb and the types of loot coming from the provision crates, and then what zones to find those in. So you can go check those out over there. Your chance at obtaining a spice when harvesting an herb is largely based on your harvesting luck and skill level. And again, we mentioned that a little bit earlier. You want to have those food buffs in place when you're going out to farming, because if you don't have any luck, you will not get any of these items. Also worth noting are the attribute bonuses you get from both Dexterity and Intellect. If you are trying to fully min-max harvesting for cooking ingredients, these attribute bonuses are worth taking. If you're wanting to skin animals and obtain such meat, the Dexterity attribute has the following bonuses related to skinning. You get plus 10 skinning speed, plus 20 haste for 3 seconds after skinning, negative 10 weight of skinned items, so this is huge, plus 10% skinning speed. So now you'll get a total of 20% increased speed, Bordy. You combine that with the tier 5 tool, dude, and you're ripping through these animals, yeah. Dude. 10% yield when skinning, which is another big thing. So Intellect gives the bonuses to harvesting that you're looking for, and that'll be plus 10 harvest to speed. You'll get that twice, which equals 20 total. 5% chance in to gain Azoth while harvesting, negative 10 weight of harvested items, and then 10% yield while harvesting. The tools, again, will also play a massive factor in your speed as you're skinning and harvesting as well. So, Bordy, here's the big question everybody's looking for. How do I level up?
All right. So we're going to talk about how to level cooking and kind of really the most efficient or effective way to level cooking in New World. So the information here is going to assume that you're going to gather all of your resources yourself. However, you do have the option, obviously, of going to purchase the raw resources from the trading post, and that'll obviously speed up your cooking level in New World. But again, this is just going to assume that we're going to gather all the materials ourselves. So in order to efficiently level cooking, you're going to want to stick with just the recovery foods, man. The attribute foods and trade foods are going to provide you with more experience per food cooked for each tier, but the amount of time that you're going to spend obtaining the raw materials for those specific foods is going to far outweigh that of recovery foods by quite a bit, because you're going to need component foods for most of those recipes, and you're going to need very specific ingredients for those recipes. And the recovery food, on the other hand, those allow you to use many different ingredients and to obtain really the same results. So the introductory quest line that you do right whenever you wash up on the shores of Eternum is going to have you craft one portion of light ration. That's going to bump your cooking up to level 1. So you'll be good. You don't have to get up to level 1 after that. So you're going to be using recovery foods to level. The leveling process is going to be split up into 4 different categories. So level 1 to 50, you're going to be crafting either travel rations or energizing rations. Those are going to yield you 24 XP per ration. Level 50 to 100, light meals or energizing light meals. Those are going to get you 90 XP per meal. Level 100 to 150 is going to be satisfying meal or energizing satisfying meal. Those are going to get you 300 XP per meal. And then level 150 to 200, you're going to be crafting a hearty meal or an energizing hearty meal, and those are going to get you 775 XP per meal that you craft. So a couple of things that you need to keep in mind prior to starting your journey down leveling your cooking are, number one, the taxes in the settlement that you're going to be doing a lot of your cooking in. So if you are kind of stationed in Everfall, for example, and that's where you want to do a lot of your cooking, if the taxes there are extremely high, you may want to think about moving somewhere else so you don't break the bank. Just go to another tier kitchen that has lower taxes. You can press M on your map and you can see the tax information there for each settlement. And then you might want to make a decision there before you really start putting a lot of time and effort into crafting at that station. So also take into consideration the tier of kitchen in your particular settlement that you're kind of stationed at, because you do have to have the same tier or above to craft the food that you're trying to craft. So you can avoid the tax altogether if you can manage to level up your camp as you go. So you can craft all the necessary recovery foods from your camp and you're not going to need a kitchen. But in order to get there, you're going to have to be character level 55 to be able to have a tier 5 camp. So, you know, you got to take that into consideration too. It's going to be a little while before you can get there. So having those in mind, that's going to save you a little bit of a headache moving forward. This is going to prevent you from having to transfer your ingredients to another town to cook, but at later levels, that might be unavoidable anyway. So also bear in mind the following ingredients needed for each tier of a meal you're going to be cooking. Keep this in mind as you're going through and gathering your stuff. So tier 2 rations, you're going to need a raw food and then a tier 2 raw food. All right, tier 3 light meal, a raw food, another raw food, and a tier 3 raw food. So to craft tier 4 food, you're going to need a raw food, another raw food, a third raw food, and then a tier 4 raw food. So you can kind of see the pattern here. Tier 5, you're going to need a raw food, raw food, raw food, a seasoning, and then a tier 5 raw food. So as you can see there, every tier of food is going to require the use of raw foods and a lot of them. So while you're in the open world, do not discount killing and skinning lower level animals, turkeys, gathering nuts, gathering honey from the towns, etc., because all those ingredients are going to remain relevant throughout your leveling process. So make sure you just gather a bunch of that stuff. So also make sure you're gathering broccoli as you go. If you come across a farm that has broccoli, gather as much as possible because you're going to need it for tier four food a little bit later on down the road. So make sure if you come across it, just go ahead and gather it. So also bear in mind that your tier five hearty meals are going to require the use of seasonings. So as you're going around gathering your other materials, make sure you're harvesting herbs, as mentioned above, as Red was talking about earlier, about how to find the spices in New World. So any seasoning, including honey, which you can get in settlements, are going to work for the tier five recovery food. So it doesn't matter which zone you're in where you're collecting the herbs. So harvest them in every zone as you go. Every zone has specific herbs. It's not going to matter which one you get. Just get as many as you can because you're going to need those for your tier five food. So also make sure you do not use your higher tier food that you loot along the way for your early levels. You're going to need tier three, tier four, and tier five ingredients for those foods specifically. So hang on to those. All right. Make sure you save them for the purpose of those tiers and don't use them for the raw food option. Always be aware of the food that you're using for your tier one raw food. So fishing is always is also a great way to gather the ingredients needed to get up to tier four. But once you hit the point of needing to craft tier five recovery food for the additional cooking experience, you're still going to need to harvest seasonings to cook tier five food. So fishing is also a pretty time consuming task to go out in the open world and do. So the time to gather the required materials is a lot longer than the other methods that are mentioned here, but you can use fishing as a viable way to collect raw materials or raw ingredients to craft your food with. So you could also work your way up to max by crafting tier four meals if you wanted to do just fishing and not harvest any spices, but you're going to use significantly more ingredients due to XP gain from tier four meals being significantly lower than that of a tier five meal. So the other method is much better. So the method of leveling that we're about to go over, we're going to go over each level from 1 to 50 or each of the four tiers we talked about earlier. It's going to utilize skinning, harvesting, and looting provision crates when available to obtain the ingredients needed to max out your cooking skills. So you can mix and match these methods any way you see fit in order to gather your ingredients. But let's jump right in here, Red, and let's talk about how you level from level 1 to 50.
All right, boys. So jumping in, starting off at level 1, you're going to use travel rations and energizing travel rations to level. These will yield you 24 cooking experience per item crafted. You'll need to gain a total of 3,450 cooking experience. So that if you divide that by 24, which is how much experience you'll get for each travel ration, you will need to craft exactly 143.75 crafting rations. So let's just round up to 144 there. Travel rations use two different ingredient types, raw food and tier two raw food. Make sure you selected the drop-down menu while you're crafting station to make sure you don't use your valuable higher tiered items to craft these. It is important to do so. You can also check out our database for more information on which ones are the easier ones to obtain. You can mix and match combinations of ingredients, but you cannot use the same ingredient twice. So you can't do chicken or turkey or whatever. You guys get the point. 144 of one ingredient and 144 of another ingredient is what you'll need to level to 50. In order to obtain the necessary ingredients, you'll want to either go to Monarch's Bluff or Everfall. Both of these zones have an abundance of raw food that you can harvest between your level before your level 50. Utilize our interactive map again for filtered by nuts, cranberries, carrots, squash, turkey nests, provision crates, and herbs. This will help you find the ingredients you'll need to craft these tier 2 energizing rations. As you gather the ingredients, kill any game you see along the way because, again, you can use those items to continue to craft further on down the line, even past 50. So you also make sure you're harvesting all the herbs too, because again, the spices will come into play as you get a higher tier. Gather any fungus you see. You'll have a chance at dropping mushrooms, which are a raw food as well. Also, every time you walk into town, make sure you're gathering the honey and the beehives. Water is also a good resource to pick up there as well. Also, remember to gather broccoli as you go. If you come across a farm that has broccoli, gather as much as possible and save it for later leveling. You will need it for your tier 4 foods. It is okay if you gather an abundance of lower tier resources as they can be used for every tier of food. So, you know, 1 through 50 is very important, Bordy, to start your prep for higher levels. Once you have at a combination of at least 144 raw food, you can head in back into town or create your camp and create 144 rations and energizing traveler rations to reach level 50. So, Bordy, now that we're level 50, what do we do? How do we get to 100, the next milestone?
Yeah, man. It follows almost the same pattern, man. Now you're just going to need 24,820 more cooking experience to get to level 100. So, in order to get that experience, you're going to start cooking light meals or energizing light meals. They both use the same ingredients. So, these are going to yield you 90 cooking experience per meal. So, you're going to need 24,820 divided by 90. That's going to give you 275.77 or 276 mils to reach 100 cooking. So in order to do this, now you're going to have to just go gather the following: 276 raw foods or combination of, another 276 raw foods or combination of those, and 276 tier three raw foods or a combination tier three raw foods. So again, Everfall is a really good choice for gathering the necessary materials. And if you go over to the interactive map, once again, it's a very great tool, especially for gathering your materials for really for any crafting, but for cooking, it works really great. Go over there and filter by elk, provision crates, herbs, berry. Do not filter by cranberry. Make sure you're filtering by berry. All right, that's very important. Blueberry, cabbage, melons, and potatoes. And then you're going to make your way to the southern portion of the zone. And in the southern portion of Everfall, you're going to find an abundance of blueberries, and there's going to be a few elk down there. You can make a loop running northwest up to the cabbage and potatoes and back around to the berries and elk until you have the required materials. So if there's a lot of competition for resources in that area, and there likely will be on launch, you can also venture south into Monarch's Bluff or Windsward. Those are a great place to harvest these materials as well. Make sure you're looting all the provision crates and herbs and killing and skinning game for later stages of leveling. We've said that a bunch, but it's very important because this will save you a lot of headache later on down the road. So it doesn't hurt to continue to harvest nuts, mushrooms, and other lower tier foods as you progress, because those are going to be needed too. So make sure you're just gathering away. Once you have the required ingredients, you're going to make your way back to a settlement that has a tier three kitchen, and then you're going to cook the amount of materials to reach level 100. So make sure you're not using your tier three food and the bottom two drop downs for raw food. All right, that's important. Do not do that. Make sure you're using only your tier one food. We say it a bunch. We want to make sure you're not doing that. All right. So, Red, how about getting from level 100 to 150?
All right, boys. So as you can imagine, and again, this is where this comes into play, Bordy. You want to take those intellect stats, increase your intellect, because you're going to be carrying a ton of food around. And by a ton, I mean a literal ton. Level 100 to 150, you're going to need 118,500 cooking experience to get from 100 to 150. In order to get that, you're now going to start cooking satisfying meals and energizing satisfying meals. These are going to yield 300 cooking experience per meal. Therefore, you will need to craft exactly 395 meals to reach level 150. In order to do this, you are now going to have to gather the following: 395 raw foods of three different combinations. So that's important. Now you're going to need three of each. This is why it's so important to continue to collect raw foods as you go about your travels in Everfall. And then at the final requirement in these recipes are going to be a tier four raw food. So by this point, you should have a decent stockpile of tier one foods. Obviously, you've leveled up quite a bit now. If not, continue to harvest them, as mentioned before. Getting the tier four raw food begins to be a little bit challenging now. You may have to visit multiple zones to satisfy the total amount needed. The meat needed for your tier four food is going to be much harder to come by due to its rarity. So your best bet is to harvest broccoli, cauliflower, oranges, and lemons. These are things you don't have to murder, guys. So much easier to get at this level. You can find broccoli by filtering on the interactive map, of course. If you're having trouble obtaining broccoli, you will need to resort to the other ingredients. You will be able to find them by looting provision crates, and you can utilize our provision crate chart and found in our quick references on the website as well. Unfortunately, going from zone to zone looting the crates can be time consuming, but of course, I mean, you're getting up into the higher tiers of cooking here, Bordy, so this will be no walk in the park. Once you have the required ingredients, head back to the settlement, go to a tier four kitchen, Bordy, this time, and then you'll need to cook those meals required to reach level 150. So, Bordy, get us home, dude. 150 to 200, max level cook. What do we need to do?
So here you go, man. You're now going to need an additional 393,750 cooking experience to get all the way to level 200 and be a master chef, man. So in order to get that experience, you're going to need to start cooking hearty meals. These are going to give you 775 cooking experience per meal. So that means you're going to need to craft 508 of these things to reach 200 cooking. So in order to do this, you're now going to have to gather 1, 2, 3 raw foods, 508 of each, 508 seasonings. That's why we were talking about gathering these spices along the way was so important, because you're going to need a bunch of them. And then 508 tier 5 raw foods. So much like the tier 4 foods, the meat is going to be a lot harder to come by than the other options. So also by this point, you should have harvested enough herbs or very close to it, as mentioned above, to have the required seasonings. If not, you're going to have to go back and harvest some herbs, man. So you should have a decent stockpile of tier 1 foods as well to use for your raw food ingredients. So your challenge now really is just going to be getting the tier 5 raw foods. So there aren't any harvestable plants that you can farm to just go get the ingredients. So you can't just go to the farms and go harvest these things. It's not that easy. You're going to have to utilize rare meat if you have any. And as we said before, it's a little bit harder to come by. So you probably aren't going to have 508 rare meat laying around. So you're probably going to have to resort then to going to provisioning crates. And you're going to have to obtain a total of 508 of the following: either rice, apples, string beans, tomatoes, or coconuts. And again, this is where that quick chart that we talked about earlier, it really comes in handy right here. So go utilize that quick chart, figure out where those ingredients are, and then you're just going to have to go harvest them. You're going to have to go from zone to zone to harvest them, or find you one zone that has a lot of provisioning crates. You're not going to be able to get all 508 from one zone, because this is a lot of ingredients you're going to have to get from these provisioning crates. But if you utilize those, plus hopefully getting a little bit of higher tier meat, you'll be able to get there fairly quickly. But I guess it is going to be quite the grind to get to 200, but that's how you get there, man. That is the path. That is the clear path to getting to 200 cooking. Obviously, Red, you can craft different things along your journey. So you may not have to craft the exact amount that we went over for each tier, because you probably will be crafting other items for your company or for your friends or even for yourself, obviously, as you go. So you'll probably be crafting yourself some trade food and some energizing. There's some meals that you're going to actually be utilizing while you play. So you probably won't have to craft this many, but this is, if you're just trying to grind, straight up grind to 200 cooking, this is going to be the best way to do it. So how about some items that's going to enhance our cooking once we reach max level, man?
Yeah. So again, we mentioned the foods that can give you some luck bonuses. There's some other items in game that can help you. So cooking bonuses or the luck, therefore, give you a chance of additional items while cooking. So, you know, again, you might have a chance to craft some extra items there. So when you're trying to cook some higher tier foods, it is good to utilize these bonuses, because again, the resources are very hard to come by. There's a chef set of armor that will increase your cooking expertise perk on the armor. Wearing this full set will increase your bonus significantly. The set can be looted from elite ancient chests, and you can see more information about that again on the database over at newworldfans.com. You will also want to utilize cooking trophies in your house when cooking important meals. These trophies, depending on their tier, can greatly enhance your cooking luck as well when pairing cooking trophies with the chef armor set. And we have a video about those trophies and how to use them in your houses as well. So we'll try to link that in the show notes down below. And then finally, we do have a cooking experience table that breaks down each level and how much experience you'll get to level. You guys can go look at that over on the website. Bordy, it's been a long one, but dude, I think there's a ton of information for our cooks out there. We're trying to look after our people, trying to min-max this for you guys. So then when New World launches, you can go right into cooking and be the first level 200 cook on your server. Make tons of money, because we all know consumables are extremely profitable in MMOs. So Bordy, thank you guys so much for watching. We really appreciate it. Don't forget to hit the subscription button, the notification bell, for more New World content like this. And again, special thank you to our Patreons. You guys are continuing to support us leading up to New World. New World's not even out yet, Bordy, and we got tons of awesome people helping us out on the Patreon. So thank you guys very much, and we'll see you in the next episode.